हरे कृष्णा, वेलकम टू क्लास भगवद गीता चैप्टर 3 टेक्स्ट नंबर 13 चैप्टर एंटाइटल कर्म योगा। द श्लोका इज यज्ञ शिष्टिनः संतो मुच्यन्ते सर्वकिल्बिषः भुञ्जन्ते ते अगम पापा ये पश्यन्ति आत्मकारणात्। The devotees of the Lord are released from all kinds of sins because they eat food which is offered first for sacrifice. Others who prepare food for personal sense enjoyment verily eat only sin. So, Bhagavad Gita Karma Yoga, we are speaking about Yajna. Very, very important thing is Yajna. Yajna Shishtinaha. Yajna Shishtinaha means the food which you prepare and offer as sacrifice to the Lord and the remnants as prasad is called Yajna Shishtinaha. Yajna Shishtinaha Santaha. So devotees, they always take only the remnants of the food which is offered to Lord Sri Krishna. Yajna Shishtinaha Santaha. Muchyante Sarva Kilbishaha. So they are released from all the kilbishas, all the sins, sinful actions, sinful reactions. Mukshyante sarva kilbishaha. Bhunjante te ago papam. Ye pashyati atma karana. So they will be released from all sinful reactions because they are eating the food which is offered to Krishna. And if the food which is not offered to Lord Sri Krishna, which is prepared only for our own sense gratification, for my own purpose, for my own enjoyment, then that is food which is prepared for our own sense enjoyment is papa, sinful. Sinful reactions come to the person who is eating the food which is offered only for her own sense gratification. So in our daily activities we are eating everything. So eating is basic, very, very, very important thing. Without eating no one can sustain, no living entity can sustain without eating. So eating is very, very important to everybody. So the karma activities start first from eating, then sleeping, then mating and defending. Ahara, Nidra, Bhaya, Maitunya. Samane etat pashupi naranam. It is for the person who is a human being, animal, bird species, animal species, any species. For everybody, food is required. Without food, no one can sustain. So the basic activity, karma, starts from our tongue. So if you eat, if you offer something to Krishna, and if you eat, then it is prasad. If you are not offering anything to Krishna and eating only for the sense gratification, then that is sinful. Sinful activity. So Krishna says in the next sloka, annat bhavanti bhutani prajanya anna sabhadra. So the food which you are eating it is coming from rains. So without rains, food is not there. So with food only we sustain. So the food which you are eating is karma, activity. But the food which is offered to Krishna becomes prasada. That is spiritual activity. So the activity as well as spiritual activity. So activity is karma. So every action has equal and opposite reaction. Even Newton says that whatever activity you do has equal and opposite reaction. If you do good, you get good. If you do bad, you get bad. So whatever activity you are doing has actions and reactions. Good action and bad action. So activities for everybody is good action and bad action. So very, very important is action performed in Krishna consciousness releases you from all the bondages. An action which is performed for your own sense gratification binds you to this material world. So ahar, nidra, bhaya, maitunya, samane etat pashupi nirana. So if you want to distinguish yourself from other animals, so we are also performing same activity, eating. Animal is also eating, dog is also eating, cat is also eating, tiger is also eating, everybody are eating, all species, everybody are eating. So we as a human being are also eating. So eating is common to everybody, the animals and human beings. So there is no distinction. The quality of happiness what a dog, cat or tiger gets in eating the grains or foodstuffs, what quality of happiness the animal gets, same kind of happiness we also get eating. The quality of happiness of human being eating, the quality of happiness of the animals eating, the quality of happiness is same. There is no difference. You might be thinking, oh, I might be eating in a very nice restaurant or very nice foodstuffs, but what happiness you are getting, the quality of your happiness and the quality of happiness of the animal in eating, same happiness, the degree of happiness is same. You get same pleasure after eating, you get some pleasure, happiness. Same pleasure, animal also get same pleasure. So the quality of happiness is same. You might be thinking, I'm in a very posh way, eating in a different style, in a different nice restaurant, in a different way. But actually, both are on the same platform, the happiness. So similarly, after eating, we sleep. So human being sleeps, animal sleeps, tiger sleeps, dog sleeps, cat sleeps. So the quality of happiness, what you get, what we get, human beings, by sleeping, we get some happiness, right? Some pleasure in sleeping. The same pleasure, quality of happiness is experienced to animals also. Dogs, cats, tiger, all animal species, they also get the same pleasure in sleeping. So you sleep and they sleep. So quality of happiness is same. There's no difference. So you are eating, then sleeping, then mating. So producing children. So dogs and animals, they are doing in the street and we are in the closed bedroom. So we are producing children. They are also producing children. So the quality of happiness, what we get in mating and what the quality of happiness the animal gets is same. There is no difference between animal and human being quality of mating. The same pleasure we get. So eating, sleeping, mating and defending. We are defending from whom? We are defending from another country by lockers, by keeping locks, treasure, and so many places we are locking different places. So different security systems we are using by nuclear weapons, bombs, arms and ammunition. And animals is using their own claws, jaws to protect themselves. So what quality of happiness the animal is getting in protecting himself and defending himself from others, and what quality of happiness what we are getting by defending in the by the nuclear weapons or by locker or whatever security system we are using. So it is same, there is no difference. Quality of happiness is same in defending by animals and human beings. So we are eating, animal is eating, we are sleeping, animal is also sleeping, we are mating, animal is also mating, and we are defending, animal is also defending. Eating, sleeping, mating, defending. Ahara nidra bhaya maitunya samane etat pashubhi naranam. So human being and animal, there is same, there is no difference between them. So what extra we are doing? So we are eating, they are also eating. So what extra we are doing? Extra is that we have intelligence, buddhi is given to human being, which is superior to other animal species. We can understand who is Lord Sri Krishna, who is God, and what who we are, and what is the purpose of our life, how to reach God, how to love God, how to serve God, that we can understand. But animals cannot understand. So basic thing to understand who we are is Dehine asmi yatha dehe kaumaram yavanam jara tatha dehantara praptis dhiras tatra namati. So basic important point to know is that we are spirit soul. So Dehi means body. We are having this body. Dehine asmi yatha dehe. Every second new cells are coming, old cells are dying. Body is totally changing. So transformation is there. So in the childhood you had small child's body, and in youth you have youth body, then middle age, then old age, and final death. So after death what happens? You get another body. So Dehinas Methade, Kaumaram, childhood, Yavanam, youth, old age, Jwara, old age. Tata Dehantra, you get another body. Tata Dehantra Praptis, you get another body. Tata Dehantra Praptis, Dhiras Tatrana, the person who is sober, who is intelligent, he will not be bewildered by such change. So we are having that intelligence, buddhi, to understand that we are different from animals, and our consciousness is that we can understand God. So now we have consciousness. So how can we know that our soul is there in my body? So we can understand it by difference between the living body and the dead body. So living body, He's having consciousness. You can see he's breathing, he's acting, he's blinking his eyes, his heart is beating. So many symptoms you can find out by which he's alive. So consciousness is there. So for the dead person, that consciousness is not there. So as soon as the soul leaves the body, even if the heart is there, brain is there, kidney is there, all body parts are there, so tell any scientist to make him alive. It is not possible to make a dead person alive. Why? Because the consciousness is gone. Means the soul is gone. So we can perceive the soul by the consciousness. So we can know that soul is there by seeing the consciousness. If the consciousness is not there, means the soul is not there. It's dead. So we should understand basically that we are spirit soul. So the first activity of the spirit soul is eating. So karma starts from eating. So here very important point to note is karma and karma yoga both are different. So I understand, many people ask me the questions. Oh, explain about karma, karma, karma. So they know about karma. So karma is different from karma yoga. Karma is the activity. Okay. What we perform in a day-to-day life is karma. And karma yoga is, yoga means what? Yoga means connecting our soul with the super soul, Krishna, Paramatma. So connecting the soul with super soul is called yoga, connection. So karma yoga means what? Performing the activities for the pleasure of the Supreme, in connection with the Supreme, for the Supreme, Nirbandhe, Krishna Sambandhe, Yukta Vairagyamuchyate. Anasaktasya Visayan, Yatharam Upayunjata, Nirbandhe, Krishna Sambandhe, Yukta Vairagyamuchyate. So whatever activity we are doing, if we are doing, do it connecting with Lord Sri Krishna. If you are connecting that yoga, then it is karma yoga. If you are not connecting it, if you are doing for your own self gratification, if you are doing for your own happiness, then Moshyante Sarva Kilbisham. All papa will be there. The food grain, one grain rice. Can anybody produce one grain of rice? So it is not possible. In the scientific laboratory, one blade of grass, one drop of blood, or one food grain, no scientist can produce. So it is given by God, by heat, light, water, Surya Devta is there, Indra Devta is supplying, rain. So Krishna is there behind everything. Prakriti is giving all Anna to us. So Krishna is behind the Prakriti. Krishna says that Swete Sa Characharam, Maya Dakshina Prakriti, Swete Sa Characharam, the all moving entities, non-moving entities, so all the whole material creation is working under my direction, Krishna's direction. So Krishna is directing everything, the whole material world. So we are getting this Anna food, one grain of rice which you are getting is given by Lord Sri Krishna. So if you are eating this one grain of rice without offering to Lord Sri Krishna, it means you are eating sin. Just like in your house, suppose you have some servant who cooks for you and gives. So the servant is cooking for you everything every day, and suddenly the servant decides that, okay, why I'm cooking for them? I'll cook for myself. And the servant cooks nice dishes and rice, biryani and paneer, pulao, this, that, puri, all big feasting. And eat by himself, servant, not giving it to the owner. So what will happen? Will you be happy? Will the servant will be happy in your presence if you are eating? No, because you are not happy. The person also will be feeling guilt, and you will not tolerate it, because you have paid the servant to serve you, not the servant himself. So if you give permission to the servant, then servant can eat. So now your question is permission. So if you give permission, then the servant can eat. Similarly, the grain of rice which we are receiving, it, the food, it belongs to Lord Sri Krishna. Ishavasam idam sarvam yat kincha jagatam jagat tena taktena bunjita magradha kasya siddhanam. Ishavasam, Isha, supreme controller. Controller, supreme controller is Krishna. Ishavasam idam sarvam, the whole material universe, Ishavasam idam sarvam yat kincha jagatam jagat. So we can, everything belongs to God, and whatever quota of happiness, distress, food or whatever we have to receive in our karma, that will be given as a quota by Lord Sri Krishna himself. You cannot go beyond it. So Krishna is controlling everything. The food of grain rice is given by Lord Sri Krishna. And if you give this one grain of rice to Lord Sri Krishna and say, oh Krishna, this belongs to you, please accept it with tulsi you give. You prepare rice foodstuffs, rice, dal, sabji, different items you can prepare. Many vegetarian items are there, which Krishna eats without onion, garlic. You can put tulsi and offer to Krishna. Please Krishna accept it. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhakta prachate. With bhakti and devotion if you give to Krishna, Krishna will accept it. After Krishna accepting it, if you take it as yagna shishtina, as a prashada, yagna offering to Lord Sri Krishna, the food grain which you are eating, whatever cooking, whatever item you are cooking in your house, put some tulsi and offer to Krishna, that becomes prashada after Krishna eating. So yagna shishtina santaha, that person who accepts the prashad of Lord Sri Krishna is a devotee. So if you accept the prashad given by Lord Sri Krishna, you become devotee. And devotees promise and they take a vaccination. Nowadays vaccination is going on. Without vaccination you cannot live. They are saying COVID vaccination compulsory. Like that they are saying. So this sloka, Bhagavad Gita, 3rd chapter, 13th sloka, Krishna is giving us the sloka of vaccination to us. This vaccination is resistance to all material contamination. So we are getting so many contaminations by eating the food which is not offered to Krishna. We eat verily sin. Sin is produced. So suppose there are 5 kind of papa shunya. One is when you are cooking it, you kill so many germs. So many living entities are dying when you are cooking. Okay. So when you are using grinding machine equipment, that time also living entities are killed. When you are using mortar and pistol, that time also you are killing the living entities. And when you are using water pot, so you are killing living entities while drinking water. And when you are brooming, cleaning your house with a broom, that time also you clean the immunity. So this 5 kind of unknown papa is incurring every day to us. First one is by cooking. Second one is by using grinding machine equipment. Third one is piston and mortar. And fourth one is by using the water pot or filter for storing water, and we kill living entities by drinking it. And fifth one is broom sticks, you're cleaning the house. So from these five activities, karma, we incur sin. So sinful activity is there in every step. Papa punya it is called. So if a person commits sin, he cannot go even to Swargloka also. Even to the heavenly planets, if a person commits this 5 unknown papa without knowing, oh, I don't know this. Well, whether you know or you don't know, there is no excuse in the law. Just like in every country, in India, you have to take left while driving traffic. In America, it is right side you have to drive. So you cannot say that there is no government, there is no traffic rules, there are no rules. You have to follow the rules. So there is lockdown means you have to follow the rules. Traffic rules you have to follow, every government rule you have to follow. So just like there is government in our state or country, similarly for the entire whole world and universe, maya dakshina prakriti svetasya characharam ishavadam idam saram yatkincha jagatam jagat. Krishna is controlling all our activities and you have to work according to the rules set by Lord Sri Krishna. So you say that no, I don't know, I have eaten this, I am drinking this, and even while walking we incur sin. So unknowingly if you commit sin, so you will not get papa, you will not get sin, it is not possible. You will be getting sin. So with that sin, you cannot go even to the higher planetary systems like Swargloka, heaven. Forget about going to Goloka Vrindavana Vaikuntha or Krishna's pastimes, entering Krishna's pastimes. So you have to be free from Sarva Kilbishah, from all the sinful activities, you have to be free. Then only you can enter the kingdom of God, by loving Krishna and serving Krishna. Munjante to abho papam. So there'll be lot of sin incurred when you're not offering the food, grains, food, what you're eating, just going to the shopping complex and buying for your own self-gratification, for my own pleasure. Whenever you go and buy things for your own pleasure, for your own self-gratification, that is called papa, according to Bhagavad Gita. I am not saying this. Bhunjante te, enjoyment. Bhunjante te, agho papa, not small papa. I am saying agho papa, more, big papa. Bhunjante te, agho papa. So you go to a shopping mall, or you go to buy some vegetables, whatever foodstuffs you want to buy. When you are buying it, you should always think that I am buying this for Lord Sri Krishna. The consciousness should be changed, that's all. So there is nothing big thing to be done. Only thing is that consciousness, the mentality should be changed. That I am buying this foodstuffs for Krishna. I am cooking this for Krishna. Then you offer to Krishna with the tulsi leaf and then you eat. Not so difficult, it's very, very, very easy. Anybody can do this. Everybody has to eat for sure, compulsory. And if you eat this, offer to Krishna, and you eat, then there will be no papa. You will get punya actually. Whoever eats the prasadam, at least once a person eats prasadam in this human birth, then next life human birth guarantee. So if you keep on eating prasad every day, every day, every day, we become devotee, we become resistant. We get just like vaccination, we get the resistance from contamination from all sinful reactions. And if you chant the holy names of Lord Sri Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, then you will be able to enter Lord Sri Krishna's pastimes, go to Vaikuntha, go or go to Vrindavan. So, Yajna is very important. What is Yajna? In this Kali Yuga, Yajna Sankirtana Praye Yajanti Sumadeshana. The person who is very intelligent, they are very, very important. That you have to change your consciousness, mentality and become intelligent. How will you become intelligent? By chanting the holy name of the Lord. Yajna, Sankirtana, Praya, Yajanti, Sumedha, this Kali Yuga, the person who is very, very intelligent, Sumedha, he will be taking to the process of chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The tongue has two activities. One is eating and another is talking. So if you chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, your tongue gets purified, and if you take Krishna's prasad, your tongue gets purified. So basic thing, talking and eating. So if you take Krishna prasad and if you talk about Krishna, think of Krishna, love Krishna, chant Krishna's name, then it gets purified. So all the karma means, with all the 10 sensory organs, you are creating activity. That is eyes, nose, tongue, ears, skin. The five working senses and five knowledge gathering senses and five working senses, that is head, hands, legs, genitals and anus. So total 10 working senses. If you are engaging these 10 working senses in the service of Krishna, then that is karma yoga. Karma, everybody says that I have to do your karma, you have to do your karma, you have to do your karma. So what karma you have to do? You have to do your karma. Without karma you cannot live. According to Sattagun, Rajagun, Tamagun, whatever state of being you are there, you have to do your karma. But you have to connect that karma with Krishna. Arjuna, in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he was resisting. He told that, I don't want to fight. I will run away from the fighting, from the battlefield. Arjuna wanted to run away. So Krishna told, no, no, you have to do your activity, karma. But that activity should be done for Krishna. That is karma yoga. So before reading Bhagavad Gita, before listening to Bhagavad Gita by Arjuna, and after listening to Bhagavad Gita from Krishna, he was a householder. Arjuna was a military commander, he was a Kshatriya. His duty is to fight. And he has wife, children, he was from royal dynasty, and all these activities he was doing. And after accepting Bhagavad Gita also, same activity he was continuing. But he was doing it for Krishna, only that consciousness changed. So if you are reading Bhagavad Gita, if you are becoming godly, if you are becoming devotee, if you are becoming Krishna conscious, God conscious, is that you are always thinking of Krishna, loving Krishna, serving Krishna, engaging all your five working senses, knowledge acquiring senses and working senses, all 10 senses, you are using it for the service of Krishna. Then you will be happy. So now you might ask the question, oh, you are telling to only Krishna, Krishna, you are telling from that time, do everything for Krishna, work everything for Krishna. Krishna is actually saying that do everything for me, work for me, everything. But you might be thinking, why he is telling only about Krishna, I am eating, I am happy, I am eating, drinking, I am being happy, whatever I want, I eat, I live my life happily. So, you will not be happy. By sense gratification, you can have practical example in your life. Whole life you are eating, sleeping, mating, defending. Animal life, the pig is there, animal is there, dog is there, he is eating all the filthy things, sleeping, mating, defending, everything is doing, all the activities. Do you think there is some transcendental happiness, spiritual happiness, ananda? So you will get ananda, real bliss, if you offer, just try this, cook, just consciousness, anyway you have to cook, without onion, garlic, only vegetarian, just cook for Krishna, try, do this once. Whatever dish you know halwa, you know rice, you know dal, whatever little bit or whatever more, whatever you want to do, just cook some dish. Today I will cook for Krishna. Cook the consciousness. You buy the ingredients of cooking for Krishna, cook it for Krishna and offer it to Krishna. And with tulsi you offer to Krishna and wait for 5 minutes and please pray to Krishna. Please Krishna, these all foodstuffs belongs to you. I have bought this for you. You are the proprietor. You are the enjoyer. So please accept all these offerings from me. So please take it. So when you give this everything to Krishna, then Krishna becomes happy. So when Krishna becomes happy, then you become happy. Just like a tree is there, roots are there. So if you are watering all the branches and twigs of the plant, then you will not be happy. When you are putting water to the root, then only the tree will be happy. If you are watering all the twigs and branches, then the tree will not be happy. So similarly, Krishna is the root. He is the owner. Bhoktaram, Yagna Tapasam, Sarvalokameshwaram, Shrudam Sarvabhutanam, Gyatanam Shantimrichate. So you get real shanti, real peace. If Bhokta, real enjoyer is Krishna, now we are trying to become enjoyer. So, just because you are trying to become enjoyer, we are suffering actually, later on. So, when you make Krishna enjoyer, when you make Krishna happy, you cook for Krishna, you do all your activities for Krishna, dovetail all your activities to Krishna, connect everything with Krishna, love Krishna, serve Krishna, then you will be happy. Yes. Otherwise, they will not be happy. You will not be happy. You will get real peace and happiness if you know Krishna is a real enjoyer, real controller and real best friend. Bhoktaram, Yajnatapadam, Sarvalokamesham, Shuddham, Sarvabhutam, Gyatavam, Shantarichati. Then you get real happiness and peace. So very, very important point here is Anna, food. You are coming from food. You are produced from food, from the food grains, Anna. So if a man is eating food grains, so that is he is chewing it and is some secretion is taking place, then it is becoming red, that is called blood, then from blood semen is produced and from semen a person is produced. So you are born from Anna. The origin, the source of your existence is Ann. So from Ann we are coming. So from where the Ann is coming? Ann is coming from rains. If rains are given by God, then you get Anna. And from where the rains are coming, if you do Yagna, if you do Harinam Sankirtan Yagna, then Devtas will give rain with the direction of Krishna. And when you are doing all your activities for Krishna, then you become happy. So it is a very simple formula. It is a vaccination for being happy. Vaccination for what? For all the material contamination, all the sinful reactions, knowingly or unknowingly. So many sins we are doing every day, every moment, every second we are incurring sin. So while walking also, while eating, while every activity there is sin. So if you dedicate all your activities for loving Krishna and serving Krishna, then it will become happy. So simple formula is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Just by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, you spiritualize your existence. Just by offering the foodstuffs to Krishna, if you're taking the Yajna Sishtana Santa, then you get spiritualized, you will get ananda. Believe me, you try this. You cook this for Krishna, food serves, and you take the prasad, you get real happiness, real ananda. It is practical. And you will feel Krishna is being happy, and you will also become happy. So this reflex action. When Krishna becomes happy, we become happy. Individually, you cannot be happy. As I was telling in previous lectures, Namayamsha Jiva Lokya Jiva Bhutya Sanatana. We are part and parcel of Krishna. When Krishna is happy, we are happy. Just like a big machine is there, and one screw is there. So we are small part of the big machine. Krishna is a big machine and we are small part of the machine. So will the small screw be happy individually? No. When the whole machine is satisfied and happy, then only the screw will be happy. So we are part and parcel of Krishna. And when Krishna is happy, we are happy. Individually we are trying to become happy now. Now the whole problem here is that we are individually trying to be happy other than Krishna. We have forgotten Krishna. Krishna bhulya jeev bhogvancha kare pashyate mayatare chapatye dhare. So we are trying to become bhoga, enjoyer. That is our real problem. We are trying to become enjoyer, but actually we are enjoyed by Krishna, then we become happy. So now we enjoy, try to enjoy, right? We whole of your life you'll see, you have eaten so many stuff, so many things, but this is unhappiness is there. So, so many people are asking questions about the coronavirus. Oh, why coronavirus is there? Why problems are there? Why Krishna is bringing problems to us? So, why so many people are dying? So many things are happening here. So, here, problems are there because there are three kinds of problems given in Bhagavad Gita. Adhyatmik, Adhibhautik, Adhidevik. Problem caused by one body and mind. Always there is some trouble. Your body is giving trouble every time before our birth in the womb. After taking birth also always problem is there with the body. And mind is also giving problem. Mind is the best friend as well as the greatest enemy. When is your mind best friend? When the mind is engaged in loving service of Lord Sri Krishna, then it is your best friend. When you are not thinking of Krishna, working for Krishna, loving for Krishna, then your mind is your enemy. You might be thinking, he is my enemy, this is my enemy, that is my enemy. No one's enemy. Your mind is your enemy. If you are not engaging your mind, the senses, body, everything to Krishna, then mind is your enemy. So Adhyatmik, problem caused by body and mind. Adhibhautik, problem caused by other living entities. This coronavirus is there by other living entities. The virus is a living entity. Coronavirus is a living entity, jiva. Just like you are a jiva, that is also jiva. There are so many jivas here. So some jiva is giving problem to us in the form of coronavirus. So that is adhibhautik, problem caused by other living entities, just like mosquitoes, tiger, or human being also, nuclear weapons, Japan, Nagasaki, Hiroshima, you can see so much of blast was there. That is also done by adhibhautik, problem caused by other living entities, either human beings, birds, animals, coronavirus, or bacteria, anything, all are living entities, part and parcel of Krishna. They are giving us problem. That is our karma. In the previous birth, you have done something, so that person is giving you no problem. In the office, in the house, any other living entity is giving you problem. That is also klesha. And third is adhidevi, problem caused by excess heat, excess cold through devatas, problems are given to us. So adhyatmik, adhibhautik, adhidevi, problem caused by body and mind, problem caused by other living entities, and problem caused by excess heat and cold. Devatas are giving us problem. And with this, there is again birth and death. Birth is a problem. 9-10 months packed up condition. And after birth also we cry. So birth is a problem, death is a problem. And old age is a problem. No one wants to become old. And disease is a problem. So birth, death, old age, disease, adhyatmik, adhibhautik, adhidevi. All the 7 problems are there. So if you want to come out of the problem, then what we should do? Yagna sishtina santahe. So you have to perform yagna. What is the yagna? In this Kaliyug, the prescribed yagna is chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, with prema, priti purvakam. Offer to Krishna the foodstuffs with priti, with love and devotion. Arjuna, starting he was not listening to Krishna. And Krishna is telling in Bhagavad Gita, do this. He was having so many questions and he was not listening. I'll do this, I'll leave the battlefield of Kurukshetra and do this. So many people are getting problems. So for his own sense gratification, he is not fighting. Arjuna wanted that his own family men, kinsmen, these all people should not be in problem. So that is his own sense gratification. He does not want to fight for his own happiness. So then later on Krishna explained it that you do all your activity for me, for Krishna. Then only you will be happy. So now we are all trying to become happy independently of Krishna. That's why we are unhappy. So just add Krishna. Increase your consciousness to Krishna. Always think of Krishna, love Krishna by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Offer whatever you promise from now onwards. That I'll eat only that foodstuff or anything which goes in my mouth, anything, water, food or anything which touches the tongue and goes inside your mouth, I will offer to Lord Sri Krishna and eat. Say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Put some tulsi, offer it and eat. It is possible. Oh, when I'm traveling in train or in flight, what I should do? Okay, sometimes time, place, circumstances, if you're going, then if you're eating, drinking some water, the railway station somewhere, you don't have time. So that time you cannot offer to Krishna. That time you can say Om Shri Vishnu, Shri Vishnu, Shri Vishnu. You can offer, say three times Vishnu or Hare Krishna mantra one time. You can say Krishna, please accept this, then you take. Then there will be no sinful reaction. So try. It is possible. Try. That is the formula to be happy actually. It's a, we are always in chain of action, reaction, action, reaction. Even scientists are told every action has equal and opposite reaction. Then we believe, right? When scientist says, Newton is saying that every action has equal and opposite reaction, then we believe. Then we accept. So scientist is also saying every action is equal and opposite reaction. So reactions are there for every action, activity. So